To get started in creating your own light-up LED cuff with a magnetic switch, knot one tail of a 12 to 15 inch piece of conductive thread. I usually run my thread through some beeswax to help keep it from curling. You'll need to hold on to the eye of the needle when sewing, since only one end of your thread will be knotted. I usually start by sewing down the negative leg of an LED. I use the thumb of the hand that I'm not sewing with to hold down the positive leg of the LED, which I've marked with red Sharpie, and then I start sewing from the back side of the fabric. To ensure a robust electrical connection, I sew between 5 and 6 loops of conductive thread around the leg of the LED. Once I've got 5 to 6 nice tight loops sewn around the leg of the LED, I sew a running stitch to within an inch of the edge of my fabric. I leave a tail coming out the front side of the fabric. It's important not to cut the tail until after you've sewn on your ring magnet. Ring magnets, in case you haven't worked with them before, are a little tricky to work with. Because they're magnetic, they can stick to your needle. But if you just put the needle through and then push it down over the thread, it'll work just fine. The object when sewing on the ring magnet is to make stitches that are close to the edge of the magnet. If you notice, my needle is entering the fabric at an angle. I'm sewing close, tight stitches all the way around the magnet so that it resembles the spokes of a bicycle wheel. I'm sewing roughly 10 to 20 stitches all the way around. The idea is that you have enough tight stitches that the magnet doesn't flop around. It should be really secure against the fabric. Then you're going to sew through the back of the fabric and secure your stitch. Using your needle, you're going to grab a little bit of the fabric and then wrap the thread around the tip of the needle and pull it through. You can do this a couple of times if you want to. Then I usually secure the thread with a dab of hot glue or some clear nail polish. This can wait till later in your process. You don't have to do it right away. And then I snip the tail. Once I've got the negative leg of my LED and the first magnet sewn down, I repeat the process by sewing down the positive leg of my LED. Like I did the first time, I'm knotting one end of a new piece of thread. I'm pinching the head of my needle as I work to keep the thread from slipping through. And I'm entering the fabric from the back side, making sure that my new piece of thread is not touching the first piece of thread, which would cause a short circuit. I then sew around the positive leg of the LED 5 to 6 times to ensure a robust electrical connection. Once I've got 5 to 6 loops of conductive thread sewn around that leg, I sew another running stitch. This time, I need to have a tail of conductive thread coming out the back side of the fabric. You'll want your tail to come out about an inch away from the rounded edge on the back side of your fabric because your fabric will be forming a loop. Before sewing on your second ring magnet, it's important to test its polarity. Place the second ring magnet on top of the first one to ensure that opposite poles are attracting one another. Once you've done this, close the fabric around your wrist to determine where you need to sew on the second magnet. Gently separate the two magnets, setting down the side of the magnet that had been facing up, and begin sewing around it like the spokes of a bicycle wheel. Repeat this process until you've ensured a robust electrical connection, using 10 to 20 tight, close stitches all the way around the ring magnet. And as you did before, you're going to grab a little bit of the fabric on the back side of the magnet with your needle and secure it with a knot, followed by a dab of hot glue or some nail polish. Then go ahead and trim the tail. All right, then it's time to make sure that your circuit works by inserting the battery. So you're going to want the positive side of the battery to be on the same side as the positive leg of the LED. And if your circuit works, fantastic. Either you or an adult will then be able to insulate the backside of the fabric using some hot glue. And once that cools off, then you can finish your artwork. If you used the planning template to brainstorm some ideas for your cuff, you might want to get that sheet out to help you remember what your ideas were. And then you can lay down your felt pieces. You can put a little cut in the piece of fabric that's going to go over your LED. You can use white glue or hot glue to secure the pieces down. And then you're finished with your light-up LED cuff.